role models that we have in front, virtually in front, those are enough for us to learn what needs to be done in the days to come. So I need to thank our predecessors, our senior bhaijans, for setting such good traditions. Thank you very much from all of us. Thank you. May Allah Almighty be with you and your families and your loved ones every step of the way. And may He accord utmost care and protection to you, to all of you. Thank you very much for sparing the effort to be here this evening. And may God bless you all. Thank you.
From First Century will share his sentiments with the August gathering. We are proud to announce that he is the senior most Sargodhian present here tonight. He too was the head boy of First Century.
Chief of the Air Staff, Air Chief Marshal Mujahid Anwar Khan, Veteran in Chief Soba, Air Chief Marshal Tahir Rafiq Bhatt, President Soba, Mr. Tasneem Nurani, Chairman SST, AVM Qasim Masood Khan, Principal BF College Sargodha, respected colleagues of Soba, and dear students, Assalamu Alaikum. I don't know what to say because whatever I wanted to say has already been said. And whether they took away my speech or I had taken away their speech is yet to be assessed. My school number is 68 and my period of stay in the school is 28th February 1953. Till 6th April 1956. This visit to the school, which is now called PF College, brings back fond memories. The first one is the first day when 100 boys from all nooks and corners of Pakistan arrived here by air in a British freighter from East Pakistan, by rail, by bus, and even on tongas. These students were like a bouquet of flowers with different fragrances and colors. This motley crowd had people like me coming from an Urdu medium school. But within a few months, the school had evened out the creases and everyone had gelled in the melting pot. Just to acquaint you with the history, we were divided into two houses, Fury and Tempest. And these houses were lodged in the Odeon building. You must all have seen it. Ground floor housing the Tempest House and the upper floor Fury House. Mr. Godfrey Stott was the housemaster of Tempest House and Mr. Hamilton of Fury House. The entry comprised of three age groups. Number one, Saeed was the youngest, and number 100, Imtiaz Shaheen, being the oldest. Prefects were appointed from amongst the older boys. I was head boy of the Tempest House, and number 87, late Mahmood Sher Masood, was head boy of Fury House. In our days, the academic staff was mostly British, led by Mr. Eric Sprossen, and we used to call him the Prince. And we also had three Pakistani teachers on board. In 1955, four purpose-built houses were completed. Tempest House was split into Sabre and Fury House into Attacker. Gentlemen, this conceptual embryo of establishment of the public schools was conceived and nurtured by the then Chief of Air Staff, Royal Pakistan Air Force Air Marshal RRL Achirley. The concept during his tenure and establishment of the schools was approved, one at Sargodhian and the other at Lower Topa. His vision can be summed up when he says, and I quote, "You are the first of the rising generation of the Pakistani boys to enjoy such an opportunity and privilege, and it is my earnest desire that you will vindicate all the hopes and aspirations which lie behind this great project," unquote. This school, under the tutelage of Mr. Alex Crossan, introduced a unique education system for harnessing the common sundry like us, with a view to producing future leaders imbued with spirit of philanthropy and patriotism for the Pakistan Air Force. The education system was based on the basic precepts of Islam, which encouraged Muslim students to offer prayers. The school also issued pocket-sized English translation of holy books, and the students they were obliged to study. This was followed by discussion on the said chapters with the renowned Islami art teacher, Mr. Zahiruddin Qazi. The academic curriculum was followed in the class through tutorial discussions to help students to understand the basic concepts which were being taught. An intensive regime of studying both English and Urdu literature enabled students to improve both spoken and written languages. The first entry is proud of the fact that it developed the school motto, "Aim High," to enthuse all of us with a vision to aim at deeds to improve their overall personality. "Aim High" instilled the Sargodhians to go through real life with achievement after achievement. Thus, the Sargodhians stand convinced that they owe a debt to the society and to the nation, which aptly made the "Aim High." A spirit of gratitude to Almighty was born, in which the Sargodhians became fortunate to pass on to others when seeking the opportunity of such an education, unique education. Gentlemen, the Sargodhians, in their own way, Soba came into existence through some few spirited Sargodhians at Karachi. And we should be grateful to them. They started this in Karachi, which was mostly a platform for meeting in the evenings. And if a lost man like me went to Karachi, they were very happy to receive me, took me to a nice restaurant, had lunch or dinner, and I had to pay for it. Today, as we stand, gentlemen, we have a Sargodhian Spirit Trust. Again, it's the continuation of this Sargodhian Spirit, or the Sargodhian Old Boys Association Spirit. We have already established a school in Tandoalayar, known as the Sargodhian Spirit Public School, Tandoalayar. And it started in 2005. Now, how this school was built and made is a history in itself. The chairman of SST is sitting here, and if you have any questions, you can ask him. He knows much more about how the school was constructed and built, how the money was collected. And we are grateful to the senior Sargodhians who made sure that we get the required amount. In this, I must mention the name of General Ehsanul Haq and General Salim Hayat. They were instrumental in getting us a lot of money, even from the President of Pakistan. Well, the school is there on the ground, and my only request to the Sargodhians is, seeing is believing. Please go and see their school for yourselves, and you would know what the school looks like. I wish you were there in the AGM today, because he showed some very nice photographs of the school. Sir, we are very grateful to the principal for hosting this tremendous show for all of us, and especially for oldies like us. When we came to the school, we didn't even have a playing ground. The ground in front of the Odeon was full of potholes and dusty. And to quote you a small little anecdote of those days, we had late Sarwat Abdullah, and we were playing hockey, and there was so much of dust, he took the ball, and we were still hitting each other, and he went to the goal, and he said, "Goal." Nobody could see what Sarwat Abdullah did. But gradually the school started coming up. Today when I look at the school, it's unbelievable. And the entire credit goes to the Pakistan Air Force. Allah bless Pakistan Air Force. Allah bless all of us and all of you. And especially, I want to offer this prayer, because what I am today, I owe it to the school. Thank you very much.
Air Chief Marshal Tahir Rafiq Bhatt, 895 Sabre, Honorable President of SOBA, to express his views. Sir, please.
Hayat Anwar Khan, respected teachers, worthy former service chiefs, young and old Sargodhians, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum. Sayyid Muhammad Khan, now that I think we see a full house, we can start with the second session of AGM to make the things more lively. So I'll take this opportunity first of all to thank our wonderful Air Chief for being here today, tonight. And I'd like to share with you that he has had to curtail his foreign visit just to be here with us tonight and join the alma mater while we are celebrating here. Thank you, Mujahid. Ladies and gentlemen, we had a get-together in Islamabad, and I had mentioned it there. So for those who are not there or not attentive, I'd like to repeat a few things. We had said that we're trying to do a few things to revitalize SOBA, as most of us are saying all the time we meet. In that, we said we'll take a few measures that the organization becomes slightly more dynamic and vibrant. In that regard, SOBA is being planned to get newly registered, a fresh registration in Islamabad, because the head office has moved there. SOBA Memorandum of Association is also under process of review, which shall be done very shortly. A Sargodhian Arz Pakistan Forum to project positive image of Pakistan has been created, and this would require support and input from all of you sitting here and not even present here. A board of advisors, which I originally wanted to call a council of elders, consisting of very senior Sargodhian members, to form a board just to guide the Sargodhians with their future endeavors and the younger Sargodhians, whether they are in SOBA or SST, to update them at least once a year about what they plan to do in the future. We also, as you, some of you heard in the morning, we also starting Sargodhian Benevolent Fund. It's being registered as a trust. This fund would support our needy Sargodhian family members through one-time financial assistance or karze hasna, depending on the requirements of the assistance-seeking family. As some of you know, Air Chief Marshal Mujahid was the first one to donate rupees 2 million for this particular cause. Few others followed the suit. Tonight, taking this opportunity, I appeal to your benevolence for donating generously for this cause so that our needy Sargodhian families can benefit from this particular setup. It must have some purpose, and I think this is one of the purposes of SOBA, that we should be able to support our needy friends. So please go ahead and donate as generously as you can. Additionally, I'm sure all of you may have already noticed that the alumni office established at the college is coming up well. The new Sargodhian website is functional and operative. I'm sure when this site gets fully developed, it would help us all to integrate better, besides realizing the real and true potential of SOBA. Here, let me acknowledge the efforts of Mr. Suhail Raza and Suhail Shafi. Are you there, Suhail Raza, Shafi? Okay. They are both developing this particular website voluntarily. Besides other functions, the website would also incorporate a feature that would assist the headhunting Sargodhian entrepreneurs to give first right of hiring to employment-seeking Sargodhians if they can make the merit of that particular job, or the children of the Sargodhians. Ladies and gentlemen, it goes without saying that SOBA is coordinating and complementing Sargodhian Spirit Trust in all its endeavors. Trust is flourishing under the dynamic chairmanship of Tasneem Noorani Bhai. He's sitting right where? Yeah, please raise your hand. Thank you. And construction of a teacher's training institute is already taken off at Rashtabad. The spade work for KPK school and some other projects is already also under consideration. In the end, I once again thank Chief Marshal and Begum Mujahid for gracing this occasion and wholeheartedly supporting the conduct of this reunion. All the concerned PSOs were ever so forthcoming in ironing out various details about the arrangements. And not to forget, I commend all Sargodhians, especially those who have traveled from abroad, to give us the pleasure of their company, including my three entry mates, Bengali friends. Before I conclude, I'll be failing in my duty if I did not thank and appreciate the principal and his entire team for their tremendous effort and relentless effort for hosting this function. I just can't tell you how much it takes to arrange this kind of function. So let's give them a big round of applause for having a job well done. To conclude, I hope and pray that SOBA continues to connect Sargodhians and enlarge its footprints in the philanthropic as well as nation-building domains, inshallah. Thank you very much.
Gentlemen, with us tonight, we have some high-profile Sargodhians who have in one contributed in its evolution as a nexus that links us all. We are also fortunate to have with us a very senior teacher who traveled all the way from United Kingdom to join us. Last year in May, the then chief of the air staff honored our mentors at the teacher's night at the air house. Sir Asim Beg Choktai was in United Kingdom and could not join us there. It will be our pleasure tonight to honor these Sargodhians and our revered teachers. Before I request our guest of honor, Air Chief Marshal Mujahid Anwar Khan, to present these mementos, I'll briefly highlight their contributions to their alma mater. Ladies and gentlemen, Sir Asim Beg Choktai served the college from 1955 to 1967. He taught not only